guys, welcome to the hangout with Donna Gets Crafty. Let's go make something. So we're starting off with a sugar bowl, a cheese shaker, and a salt and pepper shaker that I picked up at the Dollar Tree. I'm gonna remove the stickers off there, and sometimes they are stuck on with like hydraulic cement. So I like to use a heat gun to soften the glue, helps it to peel off. I love this heat cord, heat tool. It is the best one ever, 6-foot cord. So if that's something that interests you, I'll leave the link below. And look, it peels off nice and easy. If this is your first time here, thanks so much for stopping by. And if you are a return customer, thanks for coming back. I would love to have you all join me on my little crafty journey of making new stuff for my empty nest house. So just click subscribe. And if you click the bell, you'll be notified every time I put up a new video. Here, I'm just cleaning off the surfaces of the jars and shakers because the paint works a lot better on a clean surface. Best paint that I love to use is Waverly chalk paint. So I'm just gonna go ahead and give a nice coat of white, Waverly chalk paint in white. This color the paint is so thick and goes on really nice, gives a great coverage the very first layer that you do. But I did do two layers on this one because I wanted to make sure that it was quite opaque. I didn't wanna see anything. Realized there that I did not put tape over the rim, what would you call that? That little area that the cat goes on? I don't know what that's called. Anyways, if you get paint on there and then you go to put the lid on, then the lid just turns and rips the paint off. So like, you know, it's kind of pointless. So I put tape on there and went ahead and put a first coat on the second jar. So I'm really excited to be making these new things for my home. I've not started decorating for fall yet, but I have started creating lots of fall, new fall decor to have around my house. So here is a question. Do you pronounce it decor or decor? So I've been hearing on YouTube videos, a lot of people say it decor, but I've always just said decor. So I'm wondering if it's like a Brooklyn accent thing, like the difference between a radiator and a radiator, because I was growing up, we always called it a radiator. So I don't know. So how do you say the word decor? Leave me a comment. I would love to know. Here I'm just putting on the first coats, continuing on the containers. And if you look closely, sometimes if you don't wait for the paint to dry completely and you go to put another coat on, it starts to pull off the first layer. So here I was being too impatient with the paint to dry. So that's my suggestion. Wait until your paint dries before you go ahead and put the second coat on. Now, I decided that I didn't want to use black, which is the typical color that's used when you put this distressing on. I wanted to use a brown color. I really like the way it came out in the end. At first I was concerned that it was just gonna look dirty. So let me know in the comments also if you use only black for your distressing. This is the Waverly Antique Wax. And I love it because when you take a very dry brush and put very little on, you see how I'm just wiping some of it off? It just blends it so nicely because it's not a paint, it's a wax. And it really just applies and picks up the little ridges and the corners of these tiny jars in a way that I just loved the way it ended up looking. So if you ever used a color that is not black for your distressing, leave me a comment below. Let me know that I'm not alone. Here I am doing this same dry brush technique onto the larger containers. And again, the drier the brush, the better. Put such little paint on there and then you can just blend it in. That is a paper towel. Word to the wise, make sure that you're not picking up the paper towel with a big wad of color on it, because yeah, I did that and I had to kind of fix up my mess. There you can see the brown has just left a nice antiquing look. So let me know what you think about that. Now I wanna make sure that the chalk paint doesn't chip. Chalk paint can chip if you don't put a sealant on it. So I decided that I wasn't sure which Mod Podge I wanted to use, the glossy shiny or the matte. So I'm using both. And here I am using a brush from the Dollar Tree, and I like a lot of things from the Dollar Tree, many, many things from Dollar Tree. These brushes are not one of them. These little sponges break and they left little bits all over my project. So I went in and I had to clean that all off. And here I'm using a regular paintbrush, which to me worked a lot better. So I used the matte Mod Podge on the jars and I used the glossy on the small ones because I know that I'm gonna have to put a second coat on after I put these amazing stickers on. And then I'll decide if I like it matte or shiny. I'm leaving a link for a free printable below for all of these particular stickers that I made using my Cricut. You can also purchase this collection of decals in my Etsy store. They are made and measured to fit onto the Dollar Tree salt and pepper and sugar and cheese containers. So if that's something that interests you, it's Donna Gets Crafty on Etsy, or the printable below works nice, especially if you are going to be using Mod Podge to hold the paper on. I think that that would work amazing. I would suggest don't ever put them in the dishwasher. Just use a warm cloth to kind of clean them up, just in case the Mod Podge doesn't hold. So let me know in the comments below, are you getting ready for fall? Are you excited for fall? Fall is my favorite time of the year. Winter comes in second. I'm a cold weather girl. These stickers were just so much fun to make and put on. The little ridges were just a little bit challenging, so I just used a scraper just to get it, make sure that it went down into the edges nicely. And I wanted the salt and pepper shaker to have a tiny little chicken and cow, which, oh my gosh, they came out so cute. So again, you can use a printable below if you would want to have those same cute little pictures on there. So salt and pepper's ready, and there's my chicken and cow. And the sugar and cheese containers, I ended up making a much larger decal, but I still put the name sugar and cheese on it to, I don't know, identify which was which. That would probably be a useful thing, that, you know, putting Parmesan cheese into your coffee, because, you know, we have coffee early in the morning. Sometimes we're not paying attention. So I wouldn't be surprised if cheese made its way into my coffee if I didn't have the giant word cheese or sugar on the jars. So anyway, so I'd love to know what you guys think. Please, please let me know. Sometimes I think that my videos are too fast. I'm a fast talking New York girl. So if you think that my videos go by too fast, or I'm not getting my instructions out clearly, please, please let me know so that I can go ahead and take care of that. Now, this decal was the, I don't know how I would take care of it. I would start to talk slower. I'd really have to think about that. So the little jars that I have here have this seam on it, so you can see like the seam of how they I guess made the jar. And I use that to center the transfers onto the surface. Putting this on, I realized that I didn't weed out a couple of little pieces of the fence. Oops, my bad. So I went ahead and just weeded that out. And because the transfer was round, I just had to do a little snip on the bottom so that it would curve around the jar easier to get the decal on. So of course there is going to be some buffalo check, because can you ever really have too much buffalo check? So I put the little pieces on the salt and pepper shaker. I didn't put it on the larger jars because I just thought that the lid was going to cover it up too much, so I didn't put it on there. Made these little pieces of grass that kind of look like chicken feet, but I put them on there because I thought that they would be really cute using them. They're not chicken feet, they're pieces of grass, in case anybody's wondering why is she putting chicken feet on her jars. Now, I decided that I liked the way the glossy Mod Podge looked best, just giving it a final coat of Mod Podge on there. And I find painting and crafting in general, but painting is so therapeutic for me. Anybody else out there feel the same way? I mean, when I was painting the jars, I just wanted to pick up everything and just start painting stuff, because it just makes me feel relaxed, and I feel like a good coat of paint, wow, covers up a whole bunch of stuff. And here they are. Oh my gosh, aren't they the cutest stinking things ever? I am in love with them. I have created a large three-tiered tray for my kitchen table, which I'll try to remember to link the video below. And here we have our finished product. Oh my gosh, finished project. The finished project. Aren't they cute? Let me know. Do you think they're cute? Am I the only one? I just can't wait to fill them and have them on the table and just be there looking all adorable. So, I don't know. There I am, a little barn, a little house, a little chicken, a little cow. Anyway, I would just love to have you follow me along. Go ahead and click the subscribe button and click the bell, and you'll get notified. And check out my other videos, and have an incredibly crafty day. Find something to create to make your world a little bit prettier.